What are the pricing factors that go into spray foaming your pole barn? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be breaking down some factors that will lead you to the cost of insulating a pole barn with spray foam insulation. Before we get into those, please go below, hit that like button for us. So the biggest factor that will come into play when pricing out your pole barn to be insulated with spray foam is going to be the square footage of the area to be insulated. Now we're going to specifically be looking at the walls and the ceiling because obviously that's going to be the areas that you're looking to insulate. Now when you're looking at the square footage, it's the treated surface. So if we think about the square footage of a building, a lot of times you might say, oh, well, this is a 500 square foot building. Well, what that really is that would be the living space or the floor plan square footage of the building. Whether you're talking about a house or a pole barn, that's typically what people are referring to. But for this purpose, we are specifically looking at the surface that's going to be insulated. So like I said, in this case would be the actual walls and the ceiling of the barn itself. So playing off of how important the square footage factor will be, we're going to be talking about takeouts or deductions from that total square footage. Now this would obviously be any doors or windows in the walls, possibly any skylights or ventilation schemes that are going on in the ceiling area. Basically any area on the walls or ceiling that you're going to be taking out or punching through that's not going to be insulated directly. Like I said, doors and windows are the obvious things to think about. One caveat to this could be overhead doors. Now, overhead doors on a pole barn can be insulated, or even if you have sliding barn doors, a lot of times those can be insulated also with spray foam. A lot of times it's just going to be a thinner layer of foam. Keep in mind that adding foam, especially close-up if you're going to be using that, will add a lot of weight to those doors. It could make it more difficult or even stop it from closing, specifically if you have a mechanical opener on an overhead door. Just something to keep in mind. Make sure you ask those questions if you're looking at getting that overhead door sprayed. So now let's take a quick example of a pole barn. Let's say we have a 20 by 20 pole barn with 10 foot high walls. So if we do the math on that, roughly the wall price would be anywhere from $3,000 to $4,000, and the ceiling cost would be anywhere from $2,000 to $3,000. This is based on the square footage of the surface that is to be sprayed. Now obviously there is a variance in those price ranges, and part of that will be whatever takeouts need to happen. So again, any doors and windows that need to be taken out of that square footage. Now, obviously this is a simple example, but if you have a barn or if you're looking to put up a barn, please go to our website and check out our budget calculator where you can actually plug in the measurements of your pole barn and get real numbers on what you could expect if you were to have your barn sprayed. You want to learn more about the pricing factors for spray foam in your pole barn? Check out the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.